What's up guys, my name is Ace, and welcome back to another gun guide. This is a series where I go into great detail with all of the stats of every one of the weapons in COD World War II. In today's episode, we're finally going to be covering the BAR. And first up, as always, let's have a look at some of the in real life stats. So the BAR, or the Browning Automatic Rifle, is an American light machine gun that fires a 30-06 Springfield at approximately 500 to 650 rounds per minute. In COD World War II, it's in the rifle category rather than the LMG category, and it has a damage profile of 40, 30, 29. What this means is it's always going to be a 3 or 4 shot kill in core game modes, and a 1 to 2 shot kill in hardcore game modes. Our rate of fire is pretty well in line with the real life version at 571 rounds per minute, and with rapid fire we can take this up to 607 rounds per minute. Our statistical minimum time to kill is very good for the rifle category at 210 milliseconds in the 3 shot kill range, and 315 milliseconds in the 4 shot kill range. Up close, this is the fastest killing fully automatic rifle in the game. It is technically beat out by the M1 Garand, which is a semi-auto, but also keep in mind with this, it has the shortest range drop-off in the rifle category, so it's great within its maximum damage range, but the moment it drops off, which is significantly earlier than the other rifles in the game, that's when it starts to be outclassed by pretty much all of the other rifles in the game. For headshots, we get a standard headshot multiplier of 1.1, and this takes our headshot damage to a 44, 33, 31. This means that without high caliber, headshots are pretty much useless with the BAR. When you pop high caliber on, however, this takes our headshot damage profile to a 60, 45, 43. This means that at every single range, all it takes is hitting one bullet in the head to reduce the total number of shots it takes to kill. So high caliber is very powerful on the BAR. As for ranges, as you can see here, the 3-shot kill potential of the BAR isn't very good, especially for the rifle category. It drops off at just under 18 meters, and keep in mind, most rifles in this game don't drop off until 50 meters. Some of them are 38, but many of them don't drop off until that 50 meter range, so you can see that range drop off is significantly sooner than the other rifles, and this is what I was talking about earlier. Right up close, within the 3-shot kill range with the BAR, it has a clear advantage when it comes to time to kill over the other rifles. But as soon as it drops off to that 4-shot kill range, all the way out to 50 meters, it's outclassed by pretty much every rifle in the game when it comes to time to kill. That's not to say that the BAR can't compete within these ranges, it is just slightly outclassed. As for advanced rifling, the BAR is the one exception in the rifle category. All of the other rifles have their ranges doubled by advanced rifling. The BAR only gets a 30% increase to its range with this, so unfortunately you can't double that 3-shot kill potential with advanced rifling, you just get to reach out a little bit further. It's still not a terrible choice for an attachment, but it's not going to be nearly as effective as on the other rifles. As for hardcore game modes, the BAR drops off to a 2-shot kill at 37.5 meters, and once again we can extend that by 30%, taking it up to around 50 meters with advanced rifling equipped. Moving on to hipfire, this is the worst in the rifle category, tied with the FG-42, and you can see it's got quite a large hipfire spread. Moving on to idle sway, the BAR has quite a bit of idle sway for the rifle category, and this will definitely affect your shot at those mid to somewhat longer ranges. Up close, it generally doesn't play too much of a role, but when you're trying to stretch it out, this can definitely get in your way. As for recoil, the BAR doesn't kick too much, but the thing with it is it's kind of unpredictable recoil within a somewhat small area, so you don't know if it's going to kick left or right or up, but you will know that it's going to be relatively contained within a small area. It's never going to kick up to the sky for you, it's just going to be somewhat unpredictable. Getting into our magazine capacity, it's not that great for the rifle category at 20 rounds in the magazine, and this gives you 60 in reserve. Especially when you consider the rate of fire, which is decent for at least a World War II game, you will burn through these 20 round magazines relatively quickly, which is why I highly recommend extended mags, which takes it up to a 30 round magazine with 90 in reserve. Moving on to our reload add time, this is the amount of time it takes to reload without any unnecessary animations. This is just 1.39 seconds, which is quite good for the rifle category. Moving on to our handling and mobility, our aim down sight time is standard for the rifle category at 250 milliseconds, but our sprint out time, for whatever reason, is slower than the other rifles in the category at 300 milliseconds. What this means is you have to be even more careful with the BAR. You don't want to get caught sprinting because you basically just won't stand a chance in a gunfight with that really slow sprint out time. Our movement speed is standard for the rifle category at 95%, and our strafe speed while aiming down sight is also standard at 40%. So that's going to wrap it up for all of the stats of the BAR. As for my preferred attachments, I really like using quick draw on all of my rifles, basically all of my guns I use quick draw on, or most of the guns I use quick draw on. Extended mags is huge for this gun. I feel like I burned through those 20 round magazines way too quickly, so I like to bump that up to 30 rounds. The iron sights are quite good, but for competitive play, I see a lot of players using reflex sights, and I see where they're going with that. I have used reflex sight a little bit with this rifle, and for whatever reason, it just seems to help a lot. I think that might be partially due to the slightly unpredictable recoil, and it just helps you track which way your recoil is currently going so that you can counteract that a little bit. So reflex sight, I feel, is a great option as well. For public matches, high caliber is amazing. All it takes is one shot to the body, one shot to the head within the standard 3-shot kill range, and you'll be getting 2-shot kills like crazy. The only other attachments I think I would ever consider using on the BAR would be the grip or advanced rifling. Even though advanced rifling doesn't have a major impact like with the other rifles, it doesn't double your range, it only gives you that extra 30%. Oftentimes, having that extra 30% to your 3-shot kill range can be very helpful in certain situations. So getting into a couple class recommendations here, this first one is more so for public matches. We're using the infantry division, we've got quick draw, extended mags, and high caliber, and our basic training is Hunker. Our secondary is a Luger with extended mags, and our lethal is a sticky grenade. This one is amazing. Make sure you aim high, aim for that upper chest sort of area, and you'll often get one shot to the body, one shot to the head, and you'll be melting people extremely quickly with this class. Transferring the same class over to more of a competitive-oriented class, we can't have high caliber in competitive, I would swap that high caliber attachment for a reflex sight. This just allows me to stay on target a little bit better. I still like having Hunker on that class because sometimes I'm jumping on that objective when it's needed, and this is a very solid, versatile class to use in competitive play. And with that, we're gonna wrap up today's episode on the BAR. Personally, my thoughts on this gun is it's somewhat overrated in my opinion because I think a lot of people fail to recognize the drop-off is so soon for the rifle category, and from that roughly 18 to 50 meter range, this gun is statistically outclassed by most of the other rifles in this game. Up close though, it is your best bet in the rifle category, and for competitive play and the style of play for competitive, I think this is once again going to be the most viable option. The FG42 kind of took over the competitive scene, but that has since been basically destroyed and nerfed into the ground. Now for competitive play, we're pretty much left with the BAR, and we'll just have to wait and see how the gun balance and the meta changes over time. I thought this would be a great opportunity to give you guys another reminder. I'm going to organize my patch update videos into a playlist here, and I will leave that link down below, because a lot of the weapons I've already covered in this series have changed since I made the episodes on them, and if you guys are missing these patch update videos, you are going to have outdated stats. So with that, we're going to wrap up today's video. I'd like to know in the comment section below, what do you guys think of the BAR? Do you think it's that sweaty tryhard gun that's significantly better than all the other guns in the game? Or are you kind of like me and you think it might be just a little bit overrated while still being a great gun? Also, make sure you let me know in the comment section below which one of the guns you'd like me to cover next. If you enjoyed the video, a like rating is always appreciated, and don't forget to subscribe for more if you haven't already. I'll talk to you guys next time.